Welcome to the Sankalp Forum online course. I am Sarvesh Kapoor and I work in IntelliCap in their investment banking division. I help startups raise private equity and venture capital fund. In today's session, we will talk about the business due diligence process. The business due diligence process is nothing but a further deep down into your investment strategies, your business plan, so that the investment manager gets comfort in making a decision whether he would want to invest in your business or not. And if he wants to invest in your business, how much of capital should he put in your business and what amount of stake he should take. The business due diligence process is a process in which the investment manager tries to deep dive into your business, understand your business plan in a little bit more detail, visit a few plants so that he can get a more understanding of your operations, then have one final discussion with you before making a presentation to his investment committee. The investment committee consists of members who take the final decision on behalf of the fund whether to invest or not in your particular business. In this process, the investment manager would want to have an in-depth analysis of your business plan. He would want to understand the key assumptions that you have used in order to arrive at your financial projections and try and understand if these will actually hold in a market condition. So for example, he was going to look at the product or service offering that you have, the pricing that you've done for this, and whether the pricing will suit the customer profile that you're targeting. So for example, if you have an energy efficiency product and the target audience for you are 5-star hotels, the pricing could be very different than a solar lantern that you want to sell to villagers where there is no lighting so far. He will also try and understand the pricing that you have done vis-a-vis other competitors if available in the market. So take for example the solar lantern case. If there are competitors in the market that sell solar lantern for 200 rupees per piece, your pricing of the product cannot be very different from that. So for example, if you priced it at 300 rupees a piece, he will then ask you the reason why someone would buy a solar lantern for you at 300 rupees when there are competitors that sell the product for 200. So in case you do have a very compelling reason why your product is priced at a slightly higher price than what the market has, he would perhaps ask you to change your assumption to perhaps at 200 rupees a piece. On the other hand, if you have a product that you're trying to sell in a market which does not have any competitive products, then the manager would perhaps try to understand the basis of which you've set the pricing. So say for example, you are in the business of selling clean drinking water to rural India. If the pricing that you have done is 10 rupees a liter, there may be a very good need for villagers to buy clean drinking water, but they may not be able to afford it at this pricing. And the other hand, if you're trying to sell it at 10 rupees for 20 liters, there may be a very compelling case for your product. Here, if you have done some level of market surveys or on-ground research and have spoken to a few of your potential customers and have data to validate that there is a need for your product, and at the price at which you are saying, for example, at 10 rupees for 20 liters, there are people in these villages who are willing to buy your clean water, then it will go a great way in validating the assumptions that you have. The other thing the investment manager will try and understand is how much of the market share you think you'll be able to capture in the 5-year horizon, essentially the business plan that you've submitted. So say for example, you are selling a product, the market size of that product today is only 1,000 crores and it's growing at a very small pace of say 100 crores per year. And there are competitors available today that capture 600 crores of that market. And if you're estimating that you'll be able to capture 400 to 500 crores of that market in the next 5 years, it will be really uncomfortable for him to look at that business plan. On the other hand, if you're selling a product, the market size of that today is say 10,000 crores. And the demand that competitors are willing to fulfill at this point of time is only 500 crores. And then you have a business plan that says you'll be able to sell 500 crores worth of that product in the next 5 years, he will be really more comfortable looking at this business plan. After getting an estimate of how you've projected your revenues, the investment manager will also try and understand the amount of funding that you require and how you have projected that in your business plan. The funding that you may need could be for any of the three purposes. One, it could be for capital expenditure that you would need to incur to set up plants and machineries in order to manufacture your products. It could also be for working capital funding that you may have, and also for a lot of expenditures that you may incur before your business achieves break-even. That is, the revenues that you have are sufficient to meet your costs on a day-to-day basis. The investment manager will also try and understand your key assumptions on basis of which you've estimated your profitability. So, for example, he would get into understanding what kind of gross margins do you think you will be able to maintain in the product, not only today, but also going forward. Do you expect any margin pressures when other competitors enter your business or not? Or will you be able to maintain that margins even going forward? He will also try and understand what kind of office and administration expenses do you think you'll incur. So, for example, if your business is an operational-oriented business, then you'll have a lot of operations involvement and hence a lot of selling administrations and traveling costs, etc. And on the other hand, if you're a product company, then you will have more expenses related to research and development to try and understand and get more and more products in the market. During the business due diligence process, the investment manager would also like to conduct a few field visits. In case you do have a current manufacturing facility, he would want to go there and look at your facility, try and understand what are the standard operating procedures and whether those are being followed. He would also like to have discussions with your middle management and try and assess their management capabilities. You may also get requests from them to try and speak to a couple of your key customers. He is trying to understand whether your key customers actually like your products, whether they are price sensitive, or they are not satisfied with the products that you're giving right now and may shift with some other competitor in the future. After the field visit, the investment manager would like to have one final round of discussions with the promoter before he comes back with the formal proposal of the investment. In this meeting, he would like to have discussions around key findings that he had during his due diligence process, which may be different than what he understood from the promoter in the beginning. At this point, the promoter may have to come up with further arguments or data points in order to validate the assumptions that he had in the business plan. During this discussion, you may also find that the promoter may have one point and the investor may have a very contradicting point. They may have to come to a middle ground and make a few changes in the business plan so that both parties are comfortable. Post this fresh business plan, there may be one round of discussions at the same time with amount of valuations that can be expected with this business, and also the amount of dilution that the promoter would be comfortable with. The promoter and the investment manager will discuss these key assumptions in slightly more detail, and the promoter may have to change his business plan such that the investor is comfortable with the revised business plan. At this point of time, there would be some preliminary discussions regarding the valuations that the promoter is also expecting and with the level of dilutions that he is comfortable with, so that the investment manager can take the same to his investment committee. Once the investment manager is convinced about the business, he will take the case to his investment committee to take a formal decision to invest in your business. He will cover points like the business potential, the promoters and the management's capability, the risks associated with the business, the time horizon of the investment, and the possible exit strategies. The investment committee will then take a final decision on the valuations as well as how much of capital should be committed and whether it should be committed in one tranche or in a couple of tranches. And then they will give a final go-ahead to the investment manager to issue a formal term sheet. In this video, we discussed about the business due diligence process and how the investment manager gets comfortable with your business before issuing you a term sheet. In the next video, we will discuss about what to expect in a term sheet, the key clauses, and what to watch out for, and how best to negotiate a few of these clauses. I hope you found this video useful. See you soon.